you should always remember that the wave number stands for the frequency of the vibrational mode. For a better understanding of this connection, we must look at Raman's sister technique, IR spectroscopy.
Both Raman scattering and infrared absorption use photons to probe the energy difference between the vibrational states. Let's assume this difference corresponds to a photon of 1,000 wave number or 10,000 nanometer. In infrared spectroscopy, photons covering a range of energy are directed onto the sample. If one of these photons has the same energy as the energy distance between two vibrational states, it will induce vibration and is thereby absorbed. Alternatively, Raman spectroscopy can probe the same energy distance by using inelastic scattering effect of high-energy photons. Remember that here, we measure the energy loss of the scattered photons. We can use different laser wavelengths and still obtain the same information. For example, if we direct a green laser at the sample, the Raman scattered light will be yellowish-green. And if we would use blue laser, the scattered light would be green. With visible laser light, Raman spectroscopy can do many things that infrared absorption cannot, such as measuring samples in water, through a glass window, and distinguishing exceedingly small particles at submicrometer level. At the same time, visible lasers can cause problems with fluorescence by stimulating electron transitions. In the next video, I will explain this issue and tell you some tricks to avoid that.